गुड आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर सेशन एंड आवर सेशन इज ऑन द टाइम मैनेजमेंट। ओके, इफेक्टिव टाइम मैनेजमेंट। आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर माय स्क्रीन विद यू। फ्यू मोर पीपल आर इन द वेटिंग रूम। लेट मी अटेंड देम फर्स्ट। सो लेट मी शेयर द स्क्रीन। Okay. Can you see my screen?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So today we will discuss about professional skills needed to secure a job. Okay. And tips to manage time effectively. Net मत करना time. So what exactly time management is? Let's discuss about, you know, what time management is. Time management is the process of organizing and planning. Okay, how to divide your time between the specific activities. Guys, time management is nothing but it's all about organizing and planning that how to use your time in the day. If you are a student, if you are a faculty member, if you are a company worker, if you are an IT professional, whatever kind of profession you are. You must have time management skills. I have seen so many people, they used to, you know, waste their time over the, you know, social media network or social sites. That is not good. It's not ki, I'm not saying ki, you know, you must not or you should not use social media. You should use social media. You should, you know, chat with your acquaintances. You must chat with your friends. But there should be a time limitation for everything. Okay. It should not be. And one most important thing is this, that your any activity must not be skipped. All the activities what you have planned for the day must be executed or must be exercised. Okay. What you can do is, if you are giving 1 hour to any activity for every day, you can give that activity, you know, 15 minutes, 20 minutes or 30 minutes. If you are lacking on the time. Okay. That can be done in that way, but you must never skip any activity. Okay, and you can improve your ability to function more effectively even when the time and pressure is high. If you will do time management, then you can improve your ability. And in that case also, when time is tight and the pressure is very high. Okay, and who can use the time management? By whom the time management can be done? It can be done by business leaders, politicians, students, the teachers, laborers who do work on the laborer work, okay, and the working professionals. Although all these categories are covered in the working professional itself. Homemakers means the lady who work at their homes. They also can use the time management skills. This time management skills actually is to, you know, all about organizing, planning, and executing your activities of the day. And also, you know, making that or differentiate the things on the behalf of, you know, mandatory requisite. And we have a chart, but let's move ahead. We have a chart that how the, you know, activities are, you know, should take place and how they should be prioritized. Actually, for everything we do have some kind of priorities. Okay, some things used to be very important and some things used to be like, now let's discuss, you know, why we should do time management. So time management is done to save the time, to reduce the stress, so that you do not take any kind of stress, because when you do, you know, time management, then you know that at what time what should be done. And automatically, when you know that all the activities are going to be performed in this much time, then automatically your, you know, stress too becomes very less or reduced up to zero. Okay, and time management helps you to function effectively. It helps you to increase our work output, to have more control over our job responsibilities. When we do time management, then it helps us to do the or to have the control over our activities. Now, who are the time wasting culprits? How your time is, you know, wasted? One, telephone interruption. See, for example, you are studying and your studying time is, you know, 2 hours. And in mid of that, so for example, there is coming a call even that is not an important call, then also at least you need to, you know, pay attention that your call is coming. So, and if at least there is any, you know, such kind of requirement that you need to say, you need to speak that, I'll call you later on. So it takes your, you know, 4 to 5 seconds or even 10 seconds also. And most important, it disturbs your, you know, attention from the activity. Sorry? Okay. So it is telephone interruption. When you are on the telephonic call, it disturbs you. And inefficient delegations, if you have inefficient delegations, it also disturbs you. Sometimes the people to whom you don't want to pay attention, then also you have to do. Okay. And inefficient delegations means some work you have delegated to someone who cannot do it at, you know, the good level. That also is a time, you know, management culprit or time wasting culprit. Extended lunch or breaks. Say for example, your lunch timing is for 1 hour. Then if you are giving it more than 1 hour, then it also becomes a, you know, a wasting culprit. And the breaks, sometimes you take breaks. It's not like that. I am not saying you should not take breaks. It is very ideal if you take, you know, at every hour or at every 2 hours, you take 10 minutes break. It's very good because it helps us to, you know, improve our working proficiency. And next is cluttered workspace. If your workspace will be cluttered, in that case also it, you know, becomes a time wasting culprit, because in a cluttered workspace, you cannot work at your, you know, the capacity or the strength or in way that you can work upon. Poor run meetings. There are some meetings, that meeting would be with your boss, with your super boss, with the, you know, HR of the company, with any person it could be. Okay. So the meetings was to, you know, keep on doing, you know, beating about the bus. That meetings was your a lot of time. So when you're going for the meetings, then plan accordingly that what kind of meeting is going to be there. The meeting should be to the point. It should not be like beating about the bus, what was doing, going on, this. And it is good that when someone is going for a meeting, then keep your points, keep your PPT ready, whatever you are going to, you know, display there, whatever you are going to, you know, elaborate there. And next comes as a culprit is to, you know, misfiled information. When you do have some information that is misfiled, that's all, that also wastes your time a lot. Now, what are the, you know, time management skills, how you can manage your time? For managing the time, what you can do is you can set goals. You can set goals means what you need to do, what you need to do tomorrow. Okay. What you need to do now, what you need to do day before or yesterday, and what exactly your goal is, where you want to reach. Because until and unless you will not have a goal, you cannot prioritize your activities. You cannot delegate your activities. You cannot make decisions. You cannot do anything without setting the goals. Okay. First of all, set the goals that what you want to do, what is the motto behind your time management skills. And next is prioritizing. What you need to do is you need to prioritize the things, and the things can be prioritized according to urgent versus important. Urgent things need to be done right now, and important means that are to be done, but maybe they can be done, you know, tomorrow or day after tomorrow. The things what can be, you know, can be taken to little later. And we will study a complete, you know, table regarding the urgent versus important. Next, delegation. What you can do is to manage the time, you can delegate your works to someone else. Say for example, you need to, you know, pay the electricity bill. Okay. So it is not always important or always mandatory that you only go and pay the bill. But what can be done? You can ask your son, you can ask your brother, you can ask your anybody of the relatives to pay the bill. Okay. So what you can do is you can delegate others to do your works. Okay. Guys, give me a second, please. Let's call. Yes, please. So what you can do, decision making. Okay. Now, what you need to make decide, you need to decide that what decision to be done, what you need to do, what need to be done by others. So decision making should be there. Multitasking. What do we mean by multitasking? Multitasking means when one work is going on, how you can start another work. Okay, how two activities can be done at the same time. So for example, you are downloading something, okay, at the same time you can work on the Excel sheet. If you are, you know, there is something what takes time, you can keep that in the background, and the thing what do need your more importance or what do your more attention, that can be put in front of the screen. Okay, so what you can do is you can do multitasking at the same time. Two or three works can be done by individual if he or she can handle, and if the work is handleable, that also should be taken care while doing multitasking, because multitasking should not be done all the times. The works what do need your more control, okay, or what do need more attention, they should not be done while multitasking. Next is problem solving. If you know how to solve up the problems, I have seen many people, they do keep on, you know, fighting, or they keep on quarreling for the things, some things, and they are not able to, you know, take the decisions. So what you should do, you should solve the problems as quickly as possible, because it is not good to waste your time in solving the problems. Next is scheduling. What do we mean by scheduling here? Scheduling means how we do, you know, schedule the things that when what should be done. Okay, so for example, there is a meeting at 4 p.m. then a meeting has been scheduled for 4 p.m. there is a meeting with the friends that can be scheduled for 5 p.m. okay, I need to go for gym, say for example 7 p.m. then that should be for 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. And in scheduling, so for example, your, you know, timings have been shifted somewhere else. Say for example, you got stuck in, you know, traffic. Okay, in that case, in which activity time must be reduced, okay, and which activity to be skipped, that also should be done in the scheduling part itself. Okay, and then managing appointments like meeting, etc. Okay, now here are some of the tips for effective time management, how you can do effective time management. First of all, what you need to do is you need to prepare a list of the tasks in the morning or one day prior. Okay, what you can do is you can make the list one day prior or in the morning. Like the list could be paying electricity bill, ordering gas, pay phone bills, purchasing vegetables, teaching kids, renewal of the passport, ordering the gas, time for parents, fill ITR, bank transfer. These are some of the activities. Like continued, again, playing games, prepare dinner, social media, preparing presentations, office work, school or time management works, okay, exercising, then meditating and watching movies, learn new skills. These are some of the activities what you must do, okay. And now here are some of the, you know, again, tips for the effective time management. Like, do the toughest work first. When you do think that this is the tough work, then the toughest work must be done first, so that you do not have any kind of a stress and you can be, you know, more efficient and more, you can become more confident also. Okay, and next is remove distraction from your work. When you're working, then distraction must not be there. Okay, like social media, you must not use social media. I'm not saying again, you know, that you must not use all the times, but you should have a specific time for it, so that you can know about the world, that what your account is, what your friends, what your, you know, real by and who is doing what, you can come to know about that. Okay, and friends, attention must be stuck, not the district. Okay, what should be your attention must be stuck, not district. Kya kehna hai ki dhyan bhatakna nahi chahiye, atakna chahiye. So in the Hindi we do say this word, maybe many of you would be, you know, non to Hindi, like dhyan atakna chahiye, bhatakna nahi chahiye. This is attention must be stuck, not the district. And what you should do, you use of 20 and 80 formula, because 20% good habits for 80% increased productivity. If you have some good habits, then that of your 20% good habits will give you 80% results. Okay, so for example, you're writing any, you know, new essay, or you're writing any, you know, script, then if your attention is not there, then you're going to take, you know, 60% more time to write that. But if your attention is there and if you are working with the full capacity to any single activity, then your efficiency will increase by 80 to 90%. Next is take breaks between the work. Like I told you earlier, what you should do, you should take break between the works. When the work is going on, you must take, you know, break, because when you take breaks, it helps you to, you know, improve your productivity, and also it helps to, you know, give relaxation to your body so that you can work again with the full capacity. And reduce the scope of don't skip. What you should do, you should try not to skip an activity. Say for example, you goes for gym for 1 hour every day, then if at any day you are not able to find 1 hour's time for the gym, then what you should do, at least you should at least give it a 10 minutes, because do less but do at least. If you are not able to do for more time, then do at least for some time. Okay, inspire yourself all the times. When you are doing something, you should be inspired to do the things, and you must be motivated. When the time you are motivated, in that case you are always, you know, productivity always increases. Next is set up priorities. How you can set up the priorities is, you know, you can set up your priorities in the, you know, matrix of urgent versus important. See, for example, in one side I have written not important and important, in one side I have written urgent, not urgent. Okay, so if something is there what is important as well as urgent, then you must do that activity right away. Okay, see, for example, projects. If you need to make any project, then that project must be done today itself. Okay, because it's most important to be done. And examinations. If your examinations are there, then you must, you know, prepare for the examinations right away. You must not give time, or you must not give, you know, you must not make any kind of delay in it. Okay. And bills. If you need to pay the bills, then the bills must be paid on the time, because if you will not pay the bill, so for example, you are not going to pay the bill for the electricity, then your electricity would be cut off. So that should not be done. Okay. And if you are not going to pay for the, you know, bills of the gas, then gas supply will stop at your home, and it will, you know, create a huge problem. So these are the some of the activities what you must do. And in some case, what you can do, you can plan. Okay. Like, if something is important but not urgent, means something is important what you have to do at all, but not right now. Let's say, for example, I have to make notes. Then what I can do is I can make notes right now also. I can make notes in the night also. I can make notes in tomorrow morning also, because that is not urgent. Okay. And in notes also can be urgent or also as well as important also, but that depends upon the time, that at what time you are doing what. Okay. So what you can do is you can plan for it, like making notes, video and making, and exercise. When you are, you know, talking about exercise, then you should do exercise because that is important. But if at any day it is going to be skipped, then also the things can work. Okay. Next is delegate. If something is not important and if that is urgent, say for example, email is to be written, then what you can do is you can put the email, or you can write the email right away. Okay. And phone calls on the same time, what is there? Phone calls. If any phone call is, you know, urgent, then you must attend that phone call. If that is not important phone call, then you can attend that later on. And the same is in the case of meetings also. If any meeting is very important, then you must attend that. If meeting is not important, then you can do it later. Okay. Next is eliminate. If something is not important as well as urgent, then what you can do is you can do it like eliminate. You can leave it like phone calls, movie and games. If movie and, because all these three are not important, but phone call may be in both the categories, like in the delegation category as well as the, you know, elimination category, because phone call would be urgent also and not urgent or important also. So you can do in you know, as per the situation in this case. Your next comes the benefits of time management. It is like, you know, stress relief. When you are talking about, you know, time management, it gives you, you know, relief from the stress. It gives you more time. It gives you more abilities to do. Okay. and ability to realize the goals, good work life balance. When you are doing, you know, time management, then it's helps you to realize the goals, that what your goals are exactly, what you should do, what you must do, okay, and how the good work life balance can be managed. This is also done by time management only, because if you will pay more time to your, you know, work, then your family would suffer, and if you will pay more time to your family, then your work would suffer. It is in there, you know, these both the categories are vice versa. So you must, you know, manage the time accordingly. You must give time to your family also. You must give time to your work also, because both the things are mandatory. If you will leave one, then another will suffer. Okay. And while you make the, you know, time management, then you get more time, because if you, because in that time, with the help of time management, you will be able to help, you know, or you will be able to come to know that what is the activity, what should not be done, and what is the activity, what should be done, and what are the things, what can be, you know, skipped. So this was the all about for today's, you know, time management. Thank you so much, everybody. Let's come to, you know, question and answer session again, so that we can, you know, learn about the things, we can know about, you know, the requirement of the placements, etc. Stopping the screen sharing. So good afternoon, everybody, again, who joined in mid of the session. Yeah, Souvik Banerjee. Yeah, Souvik, yeah, tell me.
Yeah, if have you got any placements opportunity for us?
Not today. Actually, today I was planning for this session only. Okay, Souvik, but I sent your message also in the WhatsApp, and I have replied to you. I hope you must have received and replied from my side.
Yes, I received.
Yeah, so no problem. I have received your, you know, candidature also. And probably tomorrow or day after tomorrow, you will get a placement opportunity from my side. Not a matter of worry at all.
Okay. So Bibhor sent me some opportunity, because he is we did admission at the same time. So
okay.
He sent me some, but the pay scale is very low.
Yes, that is for initially you, they're taking you as a trainee, and later on you will be, you know, given the permanent role. That is in that way. That's why the payroll is comparatively less. Okay.
Okay, sir. So send me some good opportunity if you have.
What kind of packages you are looking for, Souvik?
Like above 20.
Above 20, great. But in that also, in that company also, package is good, yeah. That is for 3 months only. In for the first 3 months, you will be paid around 8 to 10,000. Later on, you will be paid 25,000.
So actually that company 5,000 stipend is there for I think 6 months.
Six months.
5,000, yeah, 6 months, 5,000 stipend. But after that, in one list there is mentioned based on like 17,000 something or 18 or 25, okay. Maybe, or based on your performance.
Right. No problem. So I'll also. So no problem. I'll explore something in what you can get very good packages. No, not a matter of. Yeah. Give me one day's time only.
Souvik said, I am also looking like 20K monthly packages in data analytics on Python development field.
Okay.
So
see,
if you have any good opportunity, then please.
Before, you must have received an opportunity from Foytron Cloud. Have you received that opportunity? Do you remember about that? Foytron Cloud company.
Yeah, I remember, but this is full cloud based company, so I.
Mm-hmm. And you were looking for PHP developer and data science.
No, I am looking for a Python developer.
Python, sorry,
data
sorry.
Analytics
sorry.
Or data analytics. Data analytics.
Got your point. Right.
Yeah,
right.
Or data science means as a
first. Anything in data analytics and data science?
No, that is the real, that is the, you know, major field. No problem. What I'll do is I'll probably maybe today time is 4:33. Probably tomorrow. Okay. What I'll do is I'll share a placement opportunity for data analyst profile. Okay.
Yeah.
There
okay,
is a Gurgaon based company. I'll say I have received JD from there. So I'll say
we are doing training on data analytics and data science field.
I know.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And sir, one more thing. Till now we did not get IFI tech any notifications.
Actually, she was the HR of company was calling me. You will get it today itself. Today or maybe tomorrow, for sure. Give me
so,
second.
So what is the means the first stage like test or some
test, online test will be there. Online test will be there. Give me a second, let me call her. Okay. And let me take an update right now.
Okay.
Because her call is already coming to
hey, if I apply now, then
yeah, you can apply now also. Yeah, you can apply now. Okay. No problem. So you can what you can do is you can Vibhur, hello.
Yes, sir.
Your test will be started tomorrow. Okay. I have talked to her right now.
So I'll got mail.
You will get email. You will get email from company side. Sobhik, you also will get email because your database have been shared with the company. Not a matter of worry. So let others take. You know, Manish, you want to say something?
Sir, if I want to apply it. So if
you can apply. So I think you would have filled up a Google form, na?
No, sir. From your side.
Yeah.
From IBM side. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes, I already filled up. But
no problem. Then you will get email. No problem. I have talked to her that she will share email on those mail IDs. Okay. No problem.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Sir, job. Where is the job location?
Job location for meantime it is work from home. Later on, it will be in Delhi or Bangalore.
So, sir, first round will be going on online test and second
all
round
the rounds,
is direct.
All the rounds will be online.
Okay, online. Okay. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Sir, may I know some more detail about the interviewing process?
Yeah, there is a very simple process. First of all, you have to go through a test. Then you will have to go through a interview. That is video calling interview. Okay,
sir.
Okay.
So test will be in technical like data because the cloud companies also there. No, means IFI tech is then some cloud company.
That will be data science related test. Will
because
be
we are apply for data.
They are providing us a data set, right?
Yeah.
Okay,
thank you,
sir.
So, thank you, everybody. Thank you for the day.
Bye, sir.
Bye.
Okay, bye, sir. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you. Bye, sir.
Bye. Thank you so much.